Hello everybody, and welcome back to the Poor Man's Chemist. In this video, we are going to be synthesizing beta-nitrostyrene. From benzaldehyde and nitromethane, also using sodium hydroxide, by the Henry reaction. This is a really neat bit of organic chemistry that allows carbon-carbon bond formation between a nitroalkane, like nitromethane, which we have right here, focus son of piece of shit, very nice, and benzaldehyde, that we have right here. Also very nice. We have our addition funnel here. I know it's kind of comically big, but it's the only one that I have. We have a thermometer here so that we can keep very, very careful control of the temperature. Water is not our enemy in this prep. However, high temperature definitely is. You can see over here, I have created a little windbreak, and you can see, unlike I usually do, I have typed out the prep, having scaled it down, of course, and printed it out because I have just enough benzaldehyde to try this once. So it has to work. There have been no practice runs. We are going to see if I can pull this off. Originally, the prep called for a 1500 mil flask. I scaled it down to a 250. That made it so that the prep would require 17.67 grams of benzaldehyde. Benzaldehyde has a density of about 1 gram per mil, and I got about 20 mils of it. So that worked out beautifully. But like I said, it has to go right the first time. So we are going to start off by combining 10.17 grams of nitromethane, 17.6 grams of benzaldehyde, and 33.34 mils of methanol in here, or something close to those amounts. We will put our sodium hydroxide in the addition funnel here, and then we have to cool down everything that's in our reaction flask before we add anything to it. It's got to be cooled down with an ice and salt bath to about minus 10 C. Yeah, like I said, we've got to keep everything very, very chilled for this prep. The textbook warns us that after the addition of a few mils of sodium hydroxide, you can get a sudden spike in temperature. I guess there's an induction period where it takes a little bit for it to get the reaction to get going, and then all of a sudden it can take off. So we want to be very, very careful. I've had to scale everything down to the point that I'm only using about 16 and a half mils of sodium hydroxide solution here, which is very concentrated, by the way. There's 7 grams of sodium hydroxide in this. We're going to add that shit very carefully, a drop at a time, and see if we can't pull this off. Now, another concern, the textbook says to use mechanical stirring because we are supposed to get a heavy white precipitate that is hard to stir. But I don't own a mechanical stirrer. I could not think of a way to contrive one. So I'm hoping that with having scaled everything down and I'm using a big old stir bar, that it will work out okay. I don't know, man. This is going to become a video no matter what, whether it works or not. So but I'm really hoping I can pull this off. One last thing before I get started here. The textbook warns that beta-nitrostyrene is irritating to the eyes and skin. It said it made a special note to point out that it is irritating to the skin of the face. So, yeah, you do want to be careful with it, I guess. I don't know. I've never seen beta-nitrostyrene before in my life. So I guess we're going to find out together. Anyway, here we go. All right, everyone. Our temp is down to minus 5 C. That's as low as the thermometer goes. It's been stirring here for a little while, so I think we're okay. This is our sodium hydroxide solution that has been chilling in the freezer. Add it very carefully so none goes down the sidearm. I check the stopcock. It is very tight. I am concerned because in order to transfer this into this, there's going to be a little bit of loss, but everything has been calculated and measured out exactly. So I'm going to hold on to this graduated cylinder. We're going to add this shit very, very slowly and with really good stirring. And let's hope the chem gods are with us, people. Here we go. Okay, I'm going to interrupt that because I just wanted to report what the textbook said about an initial temperature spike. It was not kidding. The textbook mentions that you can add a little bit of crushed ice to it in order to bring the temperature down to about 10°C, which is where it says that you really should try to keep it. Specifically, it says you want to keep it in a range of 10 to 15. But after the first addition, it seems like it calms down a little bit. We've still got a ways to go. I'm adding it very slowly and very carefully. When you're doing organic chemistry, man, it's kind of a dance. It requires delicacy and patience and an addition funnel that doesn't drip when it feels like it. All very important. Anyway, let's carry on. Alright, kiddies, the textbook did not lie. Boy, this stuff really, really thickened up and became an absolute pain in the ass to work with. By the end of it, I'm here with like a thermometer trying to stir it through every damn opening in this flask. Of course, once I was done adding the sodium hydroxide, I took the addition funnel off. Ended up getting shit all on the next man. It was a mess. I was afraid that was going to happen, to be honest with you. You can see when I try to stir it. I mean, it's stirring down underneath all of that, but it's not turning everything over, but that's okay. The next step in the prep is to allow this to sit for 15 minutes. Then we are going to have to add 117 mils of ice water, and it has to contain crushed ice. I made some distilled water ice cubes, so I'll be using those. I am going to go prepare that, and I will come back once that's done. Don't get this crap on your hands. I don't know, it kind of burns a little bit. Just FYI. Oh, by the way, and the selenium dioxide video, that video got a shit ton of dislikes. And when I went and I looked at the analytics graph on that thing, there was like a spike in the views where I got the selenic acid on my hand. Look, people, if that's what got your panties in a twist, I mean, nitrile gloves are like $20 for a fucking box of those things. I mean, I'm down to like my last HCl here and several other run-of-the-mill chems. Would you rather I spend money on fucking gloves or more chems to do more preps? I know what I want to do with it. Remember, kiddies, Uncle PMC is completely out of fucks to give. And if it was the other thing that happened about that time was that I made my disparaging comment about Nile Red's content saying that, you know, it was lightweight and it sucked, because I think it does. Said nothing about the man. It's not an insult to him. I just think his content has become lightweight pussyhole garbage. If that's what got people's panties in a twist, grow up. He probably doesn't like my content either. So, you know, I mean, but I don't know the guy. I have nothing against the dude personally. I just don't like what his channel's become. Again, he probably doesn't like my stuff. It all's fair on the internet, people. Anyway, I'll come back when we're ready to add the ice. All right, everyone, this stuff has been sitting for just a little bit more than 15 minutes. I think the way it reads, we have to do stuff kind of in quick succession. The first thing is to add 117 mils of water containing crushed ice to this. So that's what we're going to do now. And of course it's going to get stuck because naturally it is. All right, we're going to fudge it just a little bit. Come on, stirring. Ah, for fuck's sake. Got to do this to me now, don't you? Because of course you do. Of course you do. Get right in the way of the camera there. We'll just fuck everything up real good because I only have enough stuff to do this once. So, you know, why not? Let's just fuck it up. Yay! I knew you could do it, stuff. Oh, it's the thermometer. Okay. Oh, we don't need it quite so low anymore, do we? Okay, now, okay, clamp, you stand. Okay, chem gods, we really do have to have a talk one of these days soon. Thank you. Honestly, chem gods, why do you punish me? Are you still focused, son of piece of shit? Probably not. Probably wasn't focused for any of that. Oh, for God's sake. It never ends. It never ends. Okay, we're gonna fudge this too. This is so bad. This is so, so bad. Well, it's backyard chemistry, okay? What do you want? All right. Now, the textbook says we should get a solution, a cold solution. Looks like we're kind of along going in that direction. What is the temperature anyway? Nice and chilly, below 10 C. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Shit on my hands again. All right. Said run the resulting solution immediately, but this looks more like a suspension. Alright. Well, hey, we're gonna do what it told us to. So now we have to immediately transfer this cold solution to an addition funnel and add it to 83 mils of 4 normal HCl. This should drop out our product, I think. Says we should get a pale yellow precipitate that should settle immediately when stirring is stopped. All right, chem gods. Okay, how am I gonna do this? Let's do this this way. Maybe not quite that way. There we go. All right. This kind of all has to happen somewhat quickly. Okay, you into there. No, don't pour out the sidearm. Ah! I knew it was gonna do that. That's okay, fuck it. I don't care. I should have used a funnel with a hose on it. I knew that too. I fucking knew that and I didn't do that. Ugh, there's always something, right, kids? Okay, here we go. This should get us all precipitate, I hope. And we are supposed to add this until it is just a stream that does not break into droplets. The textbook is quite specific about this. So not quite that much. Something like that much. Whoa, don't splatter, don't splatter, don't splatter. This stuff is not supposed to be the kind of stuff you want to get on you. Whew! Damn. Oh, of course, the fucking labels in the way. Are you focused, son of piece of shit? It's kind of, I don't know, it's like a yellow, almost slightly greenish. I don't know if that's good or bad. I really wish I'd had more benzaldehyde so I could give a practice run on this thing. Although, given how hard it was to stir, I don't know that there was any way to do this where it wasn't going to be a clusterfuck on some level. This stirring now for, I don't know, maybe about 10-15 minutes while I got all of the dishes done and, you know, that we've been using, got all those washed up and everything all cleaned up, you know, clean as you go. Now we are ready to move on to the next step. So the protocol says to stop this and let it settle and decant off the liquid once it does. Hopefully, it settles out fairly quickly. And, of course, some shit has to be floating on it, because of course it does. Okay, decant most of the cloudy liquid layer. Filter the residue by suction and wash it with water until free of chlorides. Why can't we just filter it? Why do we need to do any? Wait, what? And it isn't cloudy. Okay. Alright, make a judgment call here. I know from much past experience, keep it stirred, it's going to be easier to filter. Alright, I've got the filtration set up here. It's the usual deal. Sorry, ground's a little uneven there, gotta adjust. Alright. Oh, that's great. Okay, you know what? I don't care. We'll catch it on the second round like we always do. Wow. There is a lot of this stuff. What the fuck am I gonna do with as much of this crap? Okay, maybe I'm just not even gonna fool with that because I've already got more of this shit than I know what to do with. Okay. Get off the stir bar. Come on, you fucking whore. Going to sing the You're a Fucking Whore song to you until you cooperate. Be gone, chlorides. Nobody wants you here. Yeah, ugly and smell funny. All right. We should probably rinse it more, but it looks like it might be ever so slightly soluble. And I do want to get some of it, so we're just going to stop there. All right. Now, the next step is to transfer this solid to a beaker immersed in hot water. Two layers will form, and on cooling, the lower layer of nitrostyrene solidifies and pour off the upper water layer. So apparently this is some kind of hydrate. Let's take a look at it, though. It is very nice, very pretty. Hello, son of piece of shit. Please tell me you've been focused this whole time. It's very, very nice stuff. It's a nice light yellow. Inorganic chem. Now, do you see why I like to do inorganic chem? Because this is like colorful for organic chemistry. All right, let me get some hot water going, and I'll come back when we're ready to move on to the next step. Okay, now we are ready to transfer our crude product to a pot full of hot water. It says to transfer this stuff to a beaker immersed in hot water, but we're changing it a little bit. Oh, well, it starts melting pretty damn quick. I don't know if you can see that in there. Okay, I really do not want this tipping over. We've come so far. Okay, let's see. Maybe we can, I think we can get a nice time lapse here. Stuff has melted. I hope you can kind of see that there are two layers there. Maybe if I hold it up and you can see it a little better. Well, maybe not. There are. It's just very hard for me to get it on camera, but I mean, hopefully as it solidifies here, as it cools, it will become more distinct. I say in real life, it's easy to see. Maybe if I bring you guys over this way and we zoom in a little bit. Well, can't we zoom in anymore? We're as zoomed in as we can get. There we go. Okay. Now you can see it better. Okay, everybody. I just decanted off the water and look what I found. Beautiful fucking crystals of this shit. Look at that. We're supposed to recrystallize this from hot ethanol, so I'm getting that set up now. It's going to be tricky because it says to do it through a heated funnel, which I don't have. And I'm thinking if we do this into a flask, it's just going to turn into a solid cake at the bottom of the flask, much like this, and be impossible to get out. So I'm coming up with some way to do this into a beaker. I have to improvise a little bit, but wouldn't be the first time on this channel, right? So I will come back when we're ready to do that. God, that's awesome. Okay, this is going to be quite improvised. Here is our hot ethanol. supposed to use about 14 mils of it. Oh, wow. Seriously? It does not seem appreciably soluble in it. And I did not think this stuff was going to get quite so rock solid. Oh, okay, there we go. Now the dissolving is happening. Can you even see this, guys? Okay. It's possible that some kind of dissolving is happening here. I double checked the amount of ethanol, but it does not seem to want to dissolve in it. Oh shit, I'm beginning to wonder if this was even worth it. Okay, let's try just directly heating this up and seeing if we can't get it to dissolve and recrystallize. Sorry guys, I'm having to improvise here. This stuff is not cooperating. Filtering this may be a fool's errand. Okay, it's dissolving as it gets hot. Yeah, it is going to crystallize out the moment it cools. Okay, we may just have to let it recrystallize and then try to filter it and just make do with that. Because I think this is going to crash out the moment it cools off, which is probably why the prep says use a heated filter. But I would have to have a jacketed filter for that, that ran hot water through it, and I do not have anything like that here, guys. Sorry. But, on the other hand, it looks like if you just let it cool off, it will crystallize right back out. So let's let it do that, and let's see what happens here. We'll probably lose some on our yield, but that's okay. I'm not stressing over that. I just want it to work. That's what I care about. Let's see if we can't get a time lapse of it crystallizing as it cools. All right, everyone, here is our final stuff. But before I reveal it to you, let me point out something. When the textbook says this stuff is irritating, they are not kidding, man. Somehow when I was doing the workup, I don't know. The only thing I can figure is that the wind blew a teeny tiny little dust crystal of this stuff, and it landed on my eyelid right under my eye. I didn't notice it at first, but after a minute, it was seriously starting to become irritating, and I'm like, fuck me, how do I get this thing off without smearing it in my eye? And I had to go do a full decontamination shower. So, yeah, man, on this prep, this textbook, they speaketh the truth. The truth is in them. So, here we go. Irritating or not, it's fucking glorious. Would you look at that shit? And we got a lot of it, too, man. I don't even, I don't really even know what I'm going to do with it all. Some of it, I really do want to try to reduce to phenethylamine just for the hell of it, just so I can say I did. The rest of it, I don't know. I'm not sure what to do with it. If you got any good suggestions, let me know in the comments. I'll definitely hold on to it. And, as usual, I'll post a picture of it with the weight after it's dried, and I'll give you guys what the yield finally ended up being. I would imagine it was kind of low, because I lost a good bit with that fucking filtration at the end, but, I mean, I think I've got more than enough of this to do something else with later. So, that was pretty goddamn cool, man. Very, very fun prep. Very interesting. And, very useful fucking reaction, boy. My God. I don't know how I did not know about this one. So, anyway, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't, well, whatever. Subscribe, comment, share the video. Please consider donating a few bucks to support this channel. God knows I could use it. And until the next one, y'all, I will see you later. That's pretty goddamn awesome, man. I'm quite pleased with myself.